the São Paulo Research Foundation looks for at least three opportunities when it's involved in an international collaboration for research facilities. One of them is that we require that the relevant principal investigator or principal investigators in the state of São Paulo have a relevant role in the definition of the strategies of the collaboration and of the facility. So we really want our researchers or our best researchers to be in a prominent position in terms of discussing how the facility is going to be built or which are the objectives or how it's going to be steered towards new discovery and new science. The second element, which is very relevant for us, is that we want the opportunity to bring new challenges for economic development in the state of São Paulo. That is, opportunities that will be used by small or medium or large businesses in the state of São Paulo to develop technology that will be used by that facility. We have done that since the Southern Observatory for Astronomical Research, SOAR, that FAPESP supported back in 1997. And we have been doing that in all the collaborations. Last nice result we had was with Sirius, in which about a dozen of companies in the state of São Paulo were funded by FAPESP to develop technology that was then sold to be installed in the accelerator. And the third strategy is that one of bringing young investigators to the state of São Paulo to start a career in connection to the collaboration which relates to the facility. The nice example is a researcher we brought from Italy to be a professor at the University of Campinas and who developed the best neutrino detector ever that is going to be installed at the DUNE, Deep Underground Neutrino Experiment, which is being built in South Dakota in the United States, a collaboration for an experiment which is led by Fermilab and in which a researcher from São Paulo will be key to the success of the collaboration because of the ideas that FAPESP funded him to create.